Hey everyone, welcome back to Chill Vibes Only, CVO Wellness. In today's video, we are going to be talking about the three different types of environments you could have grown up with in relation to sex. So there are the positive sex environment, a negative sex environment, or a neutral sex environment. And what we mean by those three different types is how sex was talked about and explained to you growing up as a child, and in your home, if it was something that was a positive experience and labeled in positive light, negative experience, you know, maybe there's lots of fear around it, or a neutral experience. And neutral means that, you know, it just wasn't talked about or there wasn't a lot of information or open discussion around sex in your household. So we're going to be diving into each of the three categories and talking about ways that we can try to adjust our adult experiences to see ourselves in more of a sex positive light, and open up more conversations around positivity around sex so that we feel more comfortable. We drop shame or narratives that no longer are working for us, so we can improve our overall well-being and our relationship with sex. So the first house that I'm going to be talking about is the sex negative house, because I think that this is a common one that we can see sometimes in a lot of like older types of media, just through movies and TV shows. So maybe sex was, you know, something that was really discouraged. There was a lot of fear based around sex for you. So maybe there was a lot of fear about, you know, STIs or unwanted pregnancies, or fear around the actual like process of sex, that it might be really painful or that you might not enjoy it, or you know, just a lot of fear and negativity into sex, and that sex was only meant for specific things, like to create life, and it should be only with specific people, that might have not have related to your own personal experiences. So when we grow up in sex negative households, we carry a lot of that guilt and that shame, right? You start to feel like sex is a bad thing, and you feel like maybe your desires or what you actually want and how you feel about it is wrong or not right because you're being told this narrative that's not actually aligning with your experience. So a prime example of this is maybe you're taught that sex is between a man and a woman, and you grew up your whole life thinking, you know, I would like to have sex with someone of the same sex as me, and that's, you know, portrayed in a really negative light. And that can have a lot of impact on you and a lot of shame and guilt that you might feel. So that narrative doesn't work for you. And also too, on top of that, there could be negative narratives about, you know, that sex should only be after you're married, or that sex is dangerous, or that you shouldn't ever talk about sex because it's bad for you. And those, you know, beliefs that get put on you as a kid really do come out in your adult life, right? So if you find yourself feeling really guilty about sex or feeling really shameful around it, ask yourself if you grew up in a negative sex environment. Ask yourself, you know, if your parents or your guardian or caretakers ever talked to you about sex, ever talked to you about protection, ever talked to you about safe sex and, you know, pleasure in sex, not even just safe sex, like pleasure in sex and how to enjoy sex and have fun with sex. Because it can be a really fun, exciting thing. But if we're brought up in this environment that it's negative, we're gonna have negative views towards it. So if you're someone who grew up in a sex negative environment, your goal is to try to rewrite that narrative. So, you know, making sure that when you have these negative, you know, thoughts or guilt or shame or beliefs come up, asking yourself who told you that and if it aligns with who you are today or who you want to be, and then changing the narrative and the way that we think about sex so it can be in a more positive light. Okay, so then the second type of household you could have grown up in is a sex neutral household. And so that's a household where you basically just don't talk about sex. So it's not labeled as positive or as negative, but it's just not talked about. And oftentimes when people grow up in sex neutral houses, there's a lot of confusion around sex. There's a lot of confusion about what you might like or dislike, how to have safe sex, pleasure in sex, like what it's supposed to feel like, you know, different ways to have sex, who you should be having sex with. It all will be very confusing because there was no one there who was teaching you about it or being open, and you might feel like you have to hide sex, like it's something you can't share, talk about with other people, something that's really, you know, private. But it doesn't actually have to be. And we also learn a lot about ourselves and other people through sex. So having these conversations, even though they might feel uncomfortable because you grew up in a home where it wasn't talked about regularly, is important. So what I would encourage my sex neutral household people to be doing is to start to have conversations about sex. First and foremost, specifically with your partners, if you are having sex with them, talking about what you like, what you dislike, start talking with your friends, you know, sharing stories and understanding, you know, how they got introduced to sex. One of my favorite questions to ask my friends is, you know, tell me about the last time you had sex, or tell me about your first time you had sex. The more we talk about this openly and we share, the more we're gonna feel less uncomfortable and the less taboo it will be, and we'll learn more from each other and we'll create a more positive space and environment. And then the third and final household that you could have grown up in, which I highly, highly wish that everybody got to be in this household, even though I know it's not common, but hopefully through these conversations and talking with one another, we can create more positive sex environments, and that is the positive sex household. So maybe your parents or your caregiver were super open and honest with you about protection, about, you know, pleasure in sex, about who you should be having sex with, and about listening to your needs and desires, and really were open with you and answering questions, and you might, you know, feel really positive and not feel uncomfortable when sex comes up. And so what I would encourage you to do is just to continue to pass on that energy and that positivity and share more with people who might have negative sex environments that they grew up in, or neutral sex environments, and just being really easy and empathetic with those people and understanding, because oftentimes, you know, they might not even know that they have this negative view or this uncomfortable neutral view, and you hold a lot of power in helping teach and explain to other people that it's okay and that's a positive, wonderful experience that we can talk about. So just understanding that, you know, not everybody would have maybe had the same living situation or environment that they grew up in like you did, and using that to, you know, be empathetic and also share and inspire others to maybe change their mindset around sex. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Think about what, you know, what house you might have been growing up in. If you have any questions, please feel free to DM me or comment down below. I'm always happy to help and share with you guys and talk to you guys about this stuff, because it does really help normalize the conversation, and I think it makes us all feel so much better. I personally grew up in a sex neutral household, I would say. Sex wasn't labeled as bad or dangerous, but it also wasn't talked about openly and honestly. And through these conversations and making these videos and chatting with you guys online and with my friends and with my family, I've learned to rewrite my narrative around sex to a more positive sex environment, and I love talking about it, and it doesn't feel uncomfortable to me anymore. It feels really natural and normal, and it has greatly improved my sex life, and also made me way more empathetic to people who maybe have grown up in a negative sex household, or be able to relate more to people who also grew up in sex neutral households. So that's my own personal experience with it. I highly encourage you to think about, you know, what house you're in, and then try to, you know, use some of those tips that I explained to redefine your own narrative with sex and how you want to engage with it. Yeah, I hope you guys found this video helpful. Please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe, because that really helps this channel. Give us a follow at CVO Wellness on Instagram, and we'll see you for another video shortly.